no, no. Come on, no. There's a man in there. Enough with this.
And I'm getting into it. My adrenaline's pumping. I'm about to set a casket on fire with the Undertaker in it. So I'm not thinking necessarily about my safety. So I'm dumping all this kerosene all over this casket, and it's dripping everywhere, and it's splashing, and it's hitting me, and it's on my boots, and I didn't even realize it, but my boots up to my knees were soaked in kerosene. And there was plenty of guys off to the side with fire extinguishers at the ready. And apparently, they thought they were going to need to use them because I was soaked in a flammable liquid.
You're going to burn in hell, son of a bitch. You hear me? You're going to burn.
I don't think it's on camera anywhere, but I was standing at the barricade, ready to run in to grab Randy, to like try to stop him, to slip him another lighter. And as I'm starting to go, it's like, okay, he might have it, he might have it. Thank you, Jesus.
I light it on fire, and I think, if I remember correctly, as I did that, I stepped back just in the nick of time where you saw the fire take over the casket. And I think it missed the tips of my toes by like this much.
Not real sure that the folks in the arena and what have you were real happy with how well that the casket went up. It was a spectacle to say the least.
Those are the kind of moments that people remember forever. Most of those people, they're in tune with what's been going on, and they know one thing about the Undertaker, is he's going to come out of that casket eventually, and when he does, there's going to be hell to pay.